Guys, welcome back. It's Katarina, and I hope you guys are all having a wonderful day so far. Today's video is going to be my top 5 favorite foundations for oily skin, kind of like an updated version, because as you may know, I did a video like this about a year ago, and then I also did a video like this about 2 years ago. So it's just kind of something I thought maybe I would do maybe once a year, because as you guys know, makeup companies and makeup brands are constantly coming out with new foundations, and I'm always trying new foundations, trying to find like the next best foundation. Foundation is probably my biggest passion when it comes to makeup in general. I just feel like it's so important. It's a base of your makeup. It's what everything else goes on top of. And I'm just really passionate about it. Today I wanted to come on the camera and just share again with you guys my top 5 favorites. And these are also all going to be drugstore foundations. I do also like high-end foundations, but I mean, these are foundations that I gravitate towards. These are the ones that I always choose. These are just the foundations that I stand behind 100%. So I thought it'd be fun to share with you guys, and let's get started. Also, a couple side notes is my skin type. I did want to quickly mention that too in case you are new to my channel and you don't know my skin type. I have very sensitive skin, like extremely sensitive skin, very acne prone skin. I break out so easily, it's ridiculous. So that means none of these foundations make me break out, which is also always a bonus. So I have oily skin. So I used to have extremely oily skin, and then I kind of changed to like combo oily skin, and that was back in Washington, and then I recently moved to here to where I'm now, Colorado. Ever since I've been here, my skin has been kind of more like combination with some dry patches that I'm not really used to because it's a lot drier here. With that being said, I've still been wearing all these foundations, and all these foundations work perfectly with my skin, so it's good to know that these foundations work really well with like extreme oily skin and then with oily combination skin with some dry patches as well. And this is a Rimmel Stay Matte Foundation. This retails for about $5.99. Awesome price point. That is one of the reasons I love this foundation so much. It is so affordable. Getting into the shade selection is the one con about this foundation. It only has 8 shades. That's very disappointing because this is such an amazing foundation, and I guess it's good that it's so inexpensive because if you're in between a shade, you can buy 2 different shades for still an awesome price and then customize your own. With that being said, this is True Beige number 203. It's what I'm currently wearing right now, and they only have 1 shade deeper than this, so that's kind of a bummer. Yeah, so this is the foundation that I'm wearing right now. It is so full coverage and beautiful and flawless. This foundation really reminds me of the Tarte Amazonian Clay Foundation. It has that same cream, like mousse consistency that is very, very thick, very full coverage, but it's also lightweight. So when you do blend it into your skin, you can see how full coverage it is. And even this one is actually a little bit too light for me, so I should get the darker shade now. It blends in so beautifully though. It hides your pores. Wonderful for oily skin. You don't even have to set it, and that's like crazy. When you have oily skin, you always think about setting your foundation with a powder to really lock it in and make sure you can control the shine. I actually prefer this foundation without setting it, and that's so strange to me, but it's awesome because that is one less step you have to do in your routine. Like I mentioned, I do have some dry spots with my face, and a lot of it is around my nose and then right in between my forehead area. This foundation, I don't notice to cling to any of those. Honestly, this is the foundation that I go to for like an event or for prom, anything like that. It's perfect for a big event like a wedding or something like that because it does not have any SPF in it, so it's going to not have any flashback in flash photography, which is awesome. But then with that being said, if you wear this on like a day-to-day basis or out in the spring summertime where the sun's going to be out or just in general outside, you want to make sure that you put like a moisturizer with SPF on underneath it. That way you still are protecting your skin. But for those special events, skip out on the SPF, in my opinion. That way you don't have to worry about any of that flash photography, and it's awesome. Next foundation here, this is the Revlon ColorStay Liquid Makeup Foundation. This is like an all-time holy grail foundation. I have had this foundation, not this one in particular, because I've repurchased it so many times, but I've had this foundation for years and years and years. Probably like, oh gosh, like 7 or 8 years, and I feel like there's a reason that this foundation has not been discontinued. It is just so amazing. Retails for anywhere about $9.99 to $12.99, depending on where you get it. A lot of these prices are always going to fluctuate depending on whether you're buying in a drugstore, somewhere like Walmart, if you're buying from their own personal website online in a different country. But all in all, these are pretty, pretty affordable foundations. So what I have is the formula for combination to oily skin. They do also have one for normal to dry skin as well. This formula has 20 different shades. That's a perfect amount of shade selection to me. I feel like that's such a wide range that it really can cater to anybody, and you can also customize your colors as well. This shade right here is 250 Fresh Beige. I am now getting my tan going on. If you guys saw my self-tanning routine, I'll link it down below. This is too light for me now, so typically my foundation in this is The shade I'm in is like 320, 330. This is an amazing foundation. Back in the day, I used to apply it with my fingers or a flat top kabuki brush, like I mentioned, like this guy. But my favorite way to apply this, and it's made me love this foundation even more, is with a damp beauty sponge. Whether it be the Beauty Blender, the Soho Beauty Sponge, whatever it may be, this combination for some reason is just amazing. This is a water-based formula, so it is gonna be a little bit more on the liquidy side. And I love applying more liquidy foundations with a beauty sponge for some reason. It gives the most airbrushed full coverage finish. It is gorgeous. Also, something to mention, this foundation is a very matte foundation when we put it on. I don't think I mentioned it, but the Rimmel foundation that I just mentioned earlier is like, it dries to like a demi matte finish. So this one is completely matte, which is okay because then you can go in with your own highlighting products and give yourself glows where you want to be glowy and then keep yourself matte where you want to be matte. It's just all based on personal preference. I love this foundation. It's like, I cannot say enough good things about it. Next foundation here is the CoverGirl Atlas Stay Fabulous 3-in-1 Foundation. That is a mouthful of a name, but this foundation is amazing nonetheless. This foundation's weird. I've seen the price range here from $6.99 to $12.99. That's kind of a large gap. It just, again, depends on where you get it. In terms of shades, they have around 14 or 15 shades, so it's an okay shade selection, I think. They have a good variety of shades, whether you have like cool undertones, like pink undertones, if you have a yellow undertone, if you're really fair, if you're really tan, if you have really deep skin. They have a good variety, so I'm okay with that. I love this foundation so, so much. It gives a beautiful, like, full coverage to the skin. And it looks like your skin. It's not masky. This is like a, it's more of a matte finish, but not as matte as the Revlon Colorstay makeup. But it's not like a demi matte either. It's pretty matte, but I love applying this with a damp beauty sponge. I love applying it with a foundation brush. It's a very buildable foundation. This is perfect for the spring or summertime because you can do a really light layer with it, or you can really build it up to get that full coverage look. I love this stuff. Next here is the Boots No. 7 Beautifully Matte Foundation. Does this really count as a drugstore foundation? I'm not sure because I do believe you can only get Boots Cosmetics at like Target. Correct me if I'm wrong, but I think you can only get them at Target right now. This retails for $13.99 to $14.99, so it is more on the higher end price point of drugstore foundations. But you guys, this stuff is so amazing. I'm obsessed with this. Now, this is for my girls out there who do not have extremely, extremely oily skin, because this actually dries to kind of like a dewy finish, like a demi matte to dewy finish. But once you set it, it's set in stone and you're good to go. In terms of shade selection, this comes in 14 different shades. Again, that's okay shade selection. It could be better. I really like when foundations come in 20 shades. But the formula of this is so amazing. It also is like a, and it has a pump too, which I really like. It has a kind of thicker consistency, not as thick as the Rimmel Stay Matte, but it is just a beautiful foundation. Also hyperallergenic, so you are safe if you have sensitive skin like I do. You are safe with this foundation, like all these foundations. This foundation is just so beautiful. It's a medium to fullish coverage, and it gives you such a natural looking face. It is so stunning on the skin. And like I said, it is kind of like dewy until you set it with the powder, but once you set it with the powder, you're good to go. Now with this foundation, ways I like to apply it is with a beauty sponge or a flat top kabuki like this. I don't really like applying this one with my fingers. I don't know why. I feel like you just get the best results when using a beauty sponge or a flat top kabuki. Last foundation, and probably like my current favorite foundation, is the Maybelline Fit Me Matte and Poreless Foundation. This is somewhat new within the last couple of months, and I have been just waiting for them to come out with a matte formula of this because I always wanted to try the Maybelline Fit Me Foundation. It just looks so beautiful when I watch other people's reviews, but I'm like, I have oily skin and I just knew that wasn't going to work out. So they came out with a matte formula and I was all over that. This retails for about like $5.49 to $7.99. Really, really good price point. That is an amazing price for a foundation, I think. And it comes in 16 different shades. Again, not the biggest shade selection, but for that price point, again, you can't go wrong. I have mine here today in 220 and 228. Right now, I am more 228. I could probably even go a little bit deeper than that. It reminds me a lot of the L'Oreal True Match Foundation and the Revlon Colorstay Liquid Makeup Foundation for the sense that it is a water-based foundation. My favorite way to apply this foundation is, again, either with a beauty sponge or that flat top kabuki. This foundation has a really good lasting power as well, and I like that it's a demi matte finish. So, again, it's not completely fully matte. You still get a little bit of shine, I guess you could say, but then you can also mattify that with a powder if you don't like it. It just looks very natural on the skin. It doesn't settle into my fine lines. It covers nicely. It blends beautifully, and it's just an amazing, amazing foundation. So I guess you could say this is probably my current favorite foundation, but these top five, I just stand behind 100% and I just love them. All right, you guys, so that concludes my top five foundations for oily skin. I really hope that you enjoyed it, and please make sure to give it a big thumbs up if you did. Let me know what your favorite foundation is if you have oily skin, or if you have dry skin, just let me know down below. We can all chat about it in the comment section and help each other out. I love foundation, like I said before. I am so passionate about it, and I just love testing out new foundations and really finding like hidden gems. Also, again, you guys, I will list all the information that I mentioned here in the video down below in the description box, along with, like I mentioned earlier, each individual video of the foundations that I have, like full-on tutorials and reviews of them. If any of them did catch your eye, catch your attention, and you want to know more about it and my total thoughts and really see it on the skin, I'll link those down below for you guys. Also, make sure to subscribe to my channel for new videos every Monday, Wednesday, Friday, and some bonus videos in between. Thank you so much, you guys, for watching, and I hope you have a great rest of your day. Bye, you guys.
If you guys want to check out my last video, go ahead and just click the video playing. It's a Get Ready With Me. You can also connect with me on my social medias up at the top right, Instagram and Twitter. As always, make sure to subscribe for more videos, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye!